welcome back to my channel. Today's class is going to be a yin flow to help relieve some fatigue, some stress, and some anxiety. For those of you who are new to yin yoga, just remember this really easy three principle. Hold the pose, try to remain still, and try to find something that means an edge for you. So we're going to do two blocks and we're ready to begin. Let's start in a wide-legged child's pose. So separate your knees, elongate forward, and place your forehead down onto the mat. Try to make yourself as much comfortable as you can. Here, having the forehead placed down onto the mat, it's really helpful if you feel like your mind is rushing and you can't really focus on reality. So from here, let's lift the forehead just a tiny bit. And we're going to do a variation of child's pose simply by walking the hands all over to the right. Once again, place the forehead down. Try to relax. If you notice that you're fidgeting or moving too much, it means that you went too far in the pose. Just back out a little bit. Just want the whole body to be fully heavy, relaxed, no muscles working here. Again, lift your forehead just a little bit, and we're gonna walk all the way to the left this time. resetting, relaxing. Awesome. Let's lift the forehead one last time. Let's walk the hand back to the center and really slowly take your time to lift all the way up. Let's sit on the hip. Bring the feet forward. Maybe if you need to, windshield a little bit with the knees, relieving some hip tension. One block. We're gonna lower down onto the back and place the block underneath our seats. Make sure that this is supporting well your spine and you don't feel any kind of pinching or pain in the low back. Otherwise, you just need to lower down the height of the block a little bit. Same here, mild inversion to help focusing your mind, increasing the amount of fresh blood and the brain. Decompressing, distressing. Trying to let go. Awesome, you guys. You can even stay here. Maybe this is really comfortable for you and you're having the best results from this pose. But if you want to, you can try to bring one knee at the chest at a time. Maybe extending the legs all the way up, coming into a variation of legs up the wall or waterfall. Make yourself really comfortable. let go once again. Feeling your legs becoming lighter and lighter with each exhalation. This pose is awesome for all of you who like walking or running or cycling. It helps relieving a lot of tension on your legs and a lot of swelling as well. Time. Place the feet down, lift your hips, remove the block, and then please hug the knees to the chest. Maybe rocking slightly from side to side, this helps to massage your back. Ready to relax, to do some shavasana, or maybe you want to do some more yin yoga, or that was just a warm-up for your daily practice, your daily yoga routine. If you stay with me, just place the feet down or elongate your legs. Let's take just a minute complete our practice together. Breathing deeper. Start moving your hands, your fingers, your toes and ankles. Stretch your arms overhead.
rock the knees from side to side. If you have your knees bent, otherwise bend them. And twist. Let's meet together on one side. And then let's take a seat.
Thanks for being here with me today for practicing together. I wish you a wonderful day.
Namaste.